Okay. Good afternoon. So let me introduce the AI Times Robotics and Cooking Gastronomy Project. Let me first introduce why Sony is aiming at this world, gastronomy world. This is the, you know, the picture of our founders, Mr. Morita and Mr. Iibuka. And then Sony was founded in 1945. So actually, this was the kind of very beginning of the product, rice cookers. Sony was, you know, basically radio fixing company at the beginning. So the business is fixing the radio and then get the money. But this is the first challenge by Iibuka-san, and then this is the rice cooker. Unfortunately, this is failed, and then it doesn't work anymore. So this is a kind of very symbolic product of Sony. We should challenge, even though we will fail. So this is a kind of very symbolic product. And then after that, this is the Sony building, now kind of, you know, under construction, but there is the, I don't know, the you know, the, maybe some people can see this red place is the Maxime de Paris. So this is the first full-stack French restaurant in the Japan. And then Morita-san invite the Pierre Trogras, as a very famous French chef, to so Morita-san's dream is a kind of to establish the very how to say, sophisticated people's society's place. So this is, so if you can understand, you know, first we try to build a product as a rice cooker, and then this is the kind of, you know, experience. So in 1966, so the Morita-san realized the experience is very important. And then this is the robot, which developed in the 2008, three fingers force controlled technologies. So you can see the hand and the tofu, and then this is the actually the programmer of this robot. So he can try to the force control using his real hand. So it's very dangerous trial, but it's success. So in this kind of things, this is very related, Sony is very related to the this food-related technologies and experience. So that's why I'd like to introduce these three pictures. And then at this moment, I mean, Sony has the symbolic three business categories. One is the movies, second one is music, and the third one is game. And then, unfortunately, maybe you can see this. This is the professional. This is the pointer? No. This is the professional system to support the, for example, in this movie's case, kind of director to support this system to produce the movies. And then this is actually, this is a PlayStation Network to transfer the contents to the end users. And then Sony is providing the TVs and home audios, those kind of things. So in every categories, business categories, we have the creators, artists, and the end users. And then Sony has the technology to support the creators, and also some apparatus to make the users very enjoyable. So those kind of you know, the category, this is the Sony's work. Sorry. And then, as I mentioned, maybe we can kind of make some analogy, musician and chef as creators. So Sony is go close to these creators. And then usually musician has the, you know, the play instruments like a guitar or a saxophone. And then another thing is create song and lyrics. So maybe we can divide two things like playing using the skill, and also create something new using the brain. So maybe the chef is very similar things. I think here there are several chefs, so maybe you can point out if I'm wrong. But usually chef is some skills for the cooking, like a cut, slice, boil, stir, those kind of actions. And then chef also make create a new recipes, new cuisines. So these two things is a kind of creativity. And then Sony gives some technologies to enhance or augment those kind of creativity. That is the our goal for the this project. So if you allow me, then yeah. I will introduce the concept of video, yeah. But so, maybe you have some questions.
Yeah, I mean, what I think is fascinating is I always think Sony's very visionary. So you guys are looking towards serving both creators as well as the users, and kind of giving them, the creators, the digital tool sets as food gets digitized and food starts to kind of be used by robotics and you start to map food digitally. You guys are giving the creators the tools to help them connect with the consumers, it sounds like.
Yes.
Much like you did in the past with like video entertainment, et cetera. So.
Maybe. Maybe video can yeah. You can realize yeah. In the video you have found something.
Now, you are leading this thing called AIX Robotics or AI Times Robotics. It's and you guys are doing projects at the intersection of food and robotics, right? So you guys are working with Carnegie Mellon. Uh-huh. You're doing these very forward-looking videos, kind of envisioning the future of robotics in the home, much of it tailored around food. And you have a video you want to show us. Can we can look at that and also talk about it as well, right? Want to do that?
Yes. Look into the video is better.
When I first saw this video, I thought this was like the coolest concept because like I'm a consumer tech guy and I haven't really seen a lot of like really, I mean, I think if you look at all the places in the value chain where robotics is being applied to food, the consumer space in the home is way behind everything else, like versus restaurants or distribution in warehouses. And so these guys had by far the most kind of futuristic vision that I've seen that I thought was really cool. So why don't we play that?
Okay. So we have the two videos. One is the independent living. So the situation is this gentleman will give some, will have some parties for the family and the friends, to invite the family and the friends. And then the robotics and the AI is helping the cooking of the party. So he said, cut the carrot and then to ask the robot system cutting like this. So the technology, these things is so-called imitation learning or learning by demonstrations. This is a kind of way of the machine learning. So this is very cutting edge technology. By the way, you can see some tools, which is like this one. And then those are the new tools for the chef. So some chef mentioned that he have some stimuli to make the new things using these kind of tools. Well, this is the delivery robot. So maybe like a bear robotics, this is a similar function. So this is the putting the oil on the surface of the turkeys. So we need some force control technology in order to do that. By the way, this is the projection mapping technology. We have already done this technology. And then I mentioned the AI and robotics should help the this kind of chef. So the finish or finalize must be done by human. So this is a kind of way how to collaborate. This girl can make some the decoration on the cake. So this is the kitchen case. So it's a kind of Sony's vision in the future. And the second part is the first class entertainment, which is in the airport lounge in the future. So now coupling, this pair is coming, and then robotic system serves the some cuisine because the robot system knows the, you know, the favorite things because they're using the face recognition or other things. Again, the new tools. This is the kind of wafer to make the hot things in the using the intersector. This is the hot knife. So a little bit different from the usual knife. So by the way, we are asking the real chef to make a real food in this video. And then it can measure some temperature of the meat, roast beef. And then this is a kind of new things. And then, I don't know, you can see this lady wear the, you know, rose colored clothes, and then that is rose kind of salad or something. Okay, so this is a kind of vision of the future.
Great. That's awesome.
Thank you.
So you helped build Daibo, which is one of the kind of the early kind of iconic consumer robots. You have some very futuristic visions here.
Mm-hmm.
Where are we? Are you kind of working towards building food robotics in either kind of professional scenarios or maybe longer term in consumer scenarios, much like you did the Daibo? Kind of talk about where you are on that path.
Okay. I think that when I started the Daibo project, you know, technology is not matured to build a functional or useful robot. So that is why we are going to the entertainment purpose robot. So, but at this moment, maybe the technology are getting better because, basically because of the machine learning is very, you know, very high level. So in that sense, we can do something. And then, but still the problem is the robot system is a little bit expensive, especially for the manipulators. And then, so the, our goal is to be the high-end restaurant to the robot system, and then helping the chef. And then our goal is to get the 3-star Michelin restaurant by the robotics field.
Interesting. So going back, robotics weren't at a phase yet, or the machine learning wasn't at a phase to where you can do more practical, hands-on, useful robotics, utilities. That's why you went in entertainment with Daibo. You're saying you're kind of at the stage now, and you're looking at building robotics for high-end restaurants. Do you guys have a business today, or is this like a new business you're looking to enter in terms of like serving high-end culinary spots?
The Sony has the very different companies, like Sony Music, Sony Pictures. And then in Japan, the Sony Music has started some business to run the restaurant. To support the restaurant, I should say. So in that sense, maybe we have some relation between the kind of food business already. But it's not a big one. I mean, just a selected one.
Part of what, you know, your job description that I've seen is basically helping Sony collaborate with both academia as well as startups in robotics, mm-hmm. in food robotics.
Mm-hmm.
What types of startups are you looking to collaborate with, and how are you collaborating with them today? Or, I mean, so people here that might want to work with Sony, who are you looking to work with?
We have already invest about 40 startups related to the AI and robotics, but not related one is included. But you know, we started this one about 1 year ago. So we are looking for example, in the high-end restaurant, assuming the high-end restaurant, we need some function like as you know, in the morning session, they had the front office and the back office to wash the dishes or to deliver the dishes or maybe clean up the dishes. So those kind of functions must be needed in the high-end, even though the high-end restaurant, I think. So. So I think we're going to collaborate with those kind of things. Of course, the technologies like, for example, the arm robot, because the arm robot is very various type of arm robots exist, and then price is also very different. So in that sense, maybe there's some space to make the, how to make the manipulator is a very key for this kind of product, I think.
I do think, I do want to go to the audience for questions if you guys have some. I was excited to talk to you because we haven't had a lot of consumer. I think that's kind of speaks to the state of food robotics today because it just isn't an area where the technology is mature enough where we're seeing, you know, massive scale of food robotics, high volume food robotics moving, besides something like the Rodimatic. It's more of a professional use case today. So even you, Sony, which I oftentimes identify as a consumer brand, the lens I view you through, you're looking at professional markets first with your food robotics, but you ultimately are looking at the consumer space. How fast do you see what you kind of envision there? Is that something like 20 years down the line, or do you see some of those elements coming to market in the next five years, 10 years?
Yeah, I think, of course, the Sony is a kind of very, how to say, difficult company to continue the many things. So in that sense, we need some business. Even though it is small, it's okay, but we need to find a small business. So I'm not sure consumer place is the best for the first one. Maybe the business area, like a restaurant or a professional area, must be easier than the compared with the consumers, because the consumer space is, we need to make the software, hardware, or as a very large number of the things. So if, for example, hardware, to make the hardware like 10,000 hardware is a little bit different to make the 50 number of the hardware. So Sony has that kind of, you know, the so-called manufacturing technologies or know-hows. But it's a little bit, you know, high cost. So in that sense, starting from the B2B, it's much easier to, I think, to produce.
I mean, having been there at the beginning of Ivo, I'd be interested to get your opinion, because we are seeing some startups, not really in food robotics, trying to do fully function, multifunction robots in the home, like Misty. What is your current view of some of these startups trying to do multifunction robots for the home?
I think it's good. I think, of course, the startups should challenge the new things. So Sony would like to collaborate with those kind of challengers, of course. So here the, you know, the Sony investment team, innovation fund team is there, so you can ask them to some collaborations.
Great. Does anyone have, do you have questions? Cynthia?
I feel like I've been asking a lot of questions today. So in the concept video, it looked like you were sort of advocating for the development of a lot of new tools. So on the spectrum of designing an environment for robots and sort of redesigning the human environment to cater to robots versus designing robots to function in human-centric environments, where would you say Sony lies on that spectrum? Do you think it's better to design new tools and new environments that, you know, are preferable for robots, or do you want to allow, you know, humans to continue to create their own environments and just have robots that can adapt to that? Because those are two different problems.
I'm not sure I understand your question correctly, but you know, I think the first we should discuss with the chef so that they have some, you know, the imagination or creativities, and then we should provide some tools so that they can imagine the new things. For example, the famous chef named Ferran Adrià, he started, for example, new cuisine, like the very low temperature recipes using the nitrogen, liquid nitrogen. So what he thought was, low temperature is the new texture experience for the end users. So that is his imagination. Then then we can program. But it's not, you know, just a straightforward thinking. It's a kind of interaction we need. So that is a kind of my considerations. I don't know if this is the correct answer to you or not. Sorry.
We have time for one more question. Do anyone have any more questions? Oh, one more over there.
I'm wondering if Sony has on the roadmap a $8,000 food grade robot. I think we'd all like that.
$8,000? 80,000. Oh, okay.
I only ask that because I think one big area, barrier to entry in robotics and food is the cost. Mm-hmm. We're all looking at industrial robots saying $30,000, flipping fries is hard. And we're kind of all hoping that there's a solution to that problem and wondering if that might be on Sony's roadmap.
Oh, I see. So if the this is assuming the consumer's market or professional market, maybe it depends on the situation. But for example, the arm robot is now cost about 100,000 yen. だから1000K.
How many yen?
100,000 yen. $10,000 USD. So the one arm, you know. So if we use the four arms, that's a very expensive, right? So the reason why the arm is expensive is the actuator is expensive. So in that sense, we need to reduce the actuators. So I didn't show the actuators when we use the force control. That is composed of the several devices, sensors, such as torque sensors, the very expensive gear, and the very expensive motors. So because expensive is the way of the producing or manufacturing is very limited. So if we can make some breakthrough of this one, maybe the cost will reduce. I think actually in China, the Shenzhen, they started to make the very low-cost actuators. So I think, you know, the manipulator is now very active area in the research field because many universities introduce the arm and then they start to some research works. So in that sense, maybe cost will reduce and then new application will appear or new control ways appear. So that is my view. So in that sense, maybe eventually the cost will, I don't know the ATK or the suitable or not, but reducing the cost is the kind of trend, I think.
Great. Well, thank you very much, Masahiro. Give him a big round of applause.
Thank you.
Right. And who's up next?